my speaking voice as a whirl is clear, but not hasn't been for the last week or two. I really have just been miserable with this cold. Well, to go on with what I was saying, where was I? Oh, yes. Oh, the tenor was at that time connected, but he was the manager of the Victor office in New York. And during the sermon, he wrote me a little note and said, how would you like to come down on Tuesday and make a test record for the Victor Company? Well, of course, I almost fell off my chair. I was so excited. When I look back now, everything was so exciting in those days, and I was so dizzy and so...
When did you first meet Galli-Curci?
Well, that was funny. Victor Company, every June, would have a get-together of some of the well-known artists at Atlantic City. And so we'd go down there and they'd have a big dinner party and so forth, and we'd stay for two or three days. And I remember this one morning, Werrenrath and Galli-Curci and I went in for a swim. And Werrenrath was one of my best buddies, and always teasing me if he could, getting the rise out of me. And so he dove down underneath the water and got me by the legs and tipped me over. So I did a kind of a somersault, and Galli-Curci said, oh, how clever, was that a trick? I said, yes, and it doesn't need to be repeated.
You started to tell me once upon a time about knowing Billy Murray.
Yes. Oh, I knew him so well because he did all these sort of comic records, and sometimes when we do a conglomeration of songs that were popular at that particular time, then he would be in to sing something of the popular nature. Oh, he was very full of fun and just a lovely person to know. I found through my career that the people that were truly great were the simplest and the nicest, and the near greats were the ones that felt their importance too much. I know, I think when you and Phyllis were here, I told you the story about meeting Schumann-Heink, didn't I? Well, I was singing in Chicago, the Chicago Symphony Orchestra, and Schumann-Heink and I were under the same management of the Wilson Bureau. That's way before your time, you wouldn't remember it. But it was the bureau to be identified with, and so my manager was in Chicago, and he said, how would you like to go out and meet Heink this morning? And I said, oh, I'd love to. I was so impressed, because I was young and impressionable in those days. And so then we went out, and a very grim-looking maid let us in and said we'd, and she knew this Jack, Wolfson, that was his name. And he said, Miss Kline is appearing with the symphony orchestra tonight in the symphony hall, or I guess that's what, orchestra hall. Well, anyway, so after a while we heard this patter-patter of feet, and in came Schumann-Heink, and she had flour on her hands and a dab on her cheek and everything. She said, you must excuse me, I make noodles for my boy. And so then Jack introduced me to her and said, this is Miss Kline, and of course, do you know German at all? So she said, looking at me, my 5'8", big, husky me, she said, Kline, Kline, die große Kleine, the big little one.
Yeah.
Yes, she was always. And she was at the concert that night, sat in the box, and when I came out on the stage, she leaned way over and waved at me with her handkerchief, which gave me a great thrill. Oh, yes. It's like a dream when I look back at all those days. It's fun to look back at the old days. I get my old records out now and then, listen to them, and I think, well, they made me a star on this one radio program that they gave. And they played
a wonderful program.
Oh, yes.
WNYC.
Yes, yeah. Well, I wrote him after my program was on, told him how thrilled I was and how flattered to be the main artist on that. I mean, it was devoted entirely to me. aren't you too good that you don't smoke? This is my one vice.
If that's your only vice, you get by. It's just drinking and running around with wild men that's really scary.
Well, I wish I was young enough to do that, too. Well, the one other vice I have is to have a cocktail every night before my dinner.
That's not vice.
No, that's just a great pleasure. And I said to the doctor one time, he said, how much do you drink? And I said, oh, just one cocktail for dinner. He said, well, keep it up, it does you good. All I hope is that I don't lose my, I don't want to become senile as so many older people do.
Well, you're not.
Sure. No, I know that I had a letter from my sister-in-law recently, and she's spending the winter in Mexico, and she said, your letters are such fun, because she said, I can still, when I read them, I always think, well, Ollie still has all her buttons.
You sure do.